The Bishop of Namirembe Diocese, Wilberforce Chitiolu Walira, has served in this position for the last 14 years. And now, after making the age of 65, he has to retire as mandated by the Church of Uganda's constitution. In this regard, he bid farewell to Christians in the diocese when he visited a prominent church institution in Mengo Senior School, where he was welcomed by top school management. The head teacher of the school talked about a remarkable journey with the bishop, and they donated a number of gifts, including a cow, as a sign of appreciation.
We pledge to be our best, to do our best, and let God do the rest. May God be with you always.
During his speech, Bishop Luwalira acknowledged the support rendered to him during his service.
We have had a wonderful time meeting you on the way, in the morning and in the evening. And all the 14 years, thank you for receiving us every year as we would be coming for ministry in this school. We have had a wonderful time with you, and we pray that God will continue to bless you as you continue in his love and service. We love you, and we pray that God would continue to shower his blessings upon your lives. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Bishop Luwalira then led a confirmation service where over 170 students were confirmed in the Christian faith. He appealed to parents, teachers, and guardians to desist from involving confirmed children in non-godly activities. After the service, the bishop inaugurated a storied building for which he did groundbreaking before the outbreak of COVID-19. He also did groundbreaking for a state-of-the-art dining building that will be multipurpose, according to Grace Nantaja.
Had an opportunity for him commissioning for us our new building, the laboratory and library block, which costed us about 6.4 billion. We have been able to commission it today. He has also been able to do for us groundbreaking of a multi-purpose hall, which we intend to build at this place. So we want to thank God for all.
Report compiled by Ismail Subuga for the news.
This is my